John chapter 2, at the wedding, the wine finishes, the mother intervenes, she says to them, whatever he tells you to do, do it. And Jesus comes and truly he tells them to do something. He tells them to do something. He says to them, get water pots and fill them with water. That's the first step. So the first thing you must do to get your miracle from God is to hear from God, is to get an instruction from God. Without a specific instruction from God for your matter, you will just be going around the circles. You'll just be confessing. But when you hear a word from God, 50% of the problem is solved. 50% of the problem is solved. Once you hear from God, Jesus gave them an instruction. He said, fill the water pots with water. That was the first instruction. The second instruction was, draw out from the water and take it to the man. That was the second instruction. So, the mother advised them and they heard. In the walk of faith, after you have done all what I said on Sunday, you must now come, Father, give me the specific word on how to go to America. I have gotten my information, I have meditated, I have believed, now I see the pictures. What should I do? What must I do? What is the next thing? If you can get a word from God, 50% of the thing is solved. If you wait on the Lord, he will tell you what specific thing for your own specific miracle. It means that henceforth, you are no longer just going to claim anything you see in scripture. Did you hear me? Oh, by his stripes, you were healed. That is the truth. It's the general truth. But that is not God's instruction to you. It's the general word. That's why we confess, by his stripes, I'm healed by, and the people still die. Why? Because they never got a specific instruction on what to do. I will show you from the word of God. For everything in your life, there is a word that you must hear from God. So you will no longer just take the Bible and say, none shall lack their meat. That's the general truth. But Father, what is my word? How do I get my meat? Tell me what to do. Tell me what to do. Now, there are three ways God can speak to you when you ask him to speak to you. The first one is, there are times you will audibly hear a voice. Go to this person. Talk to that person. Do this. You will. Have you turned around sometimes to see who was speaking? Sometimes that is God. And whichever way God chooses to speak to you, you must respond by faith. It must be by faith. You must hear it by faith, because you can hear a voice and say, no, that was me. So even in hearing the voice, there must be faith. So you can hear a voice say, do this in your room. It will be so loud, it will be so clear. You can hear God say, give that 1 million to this person. And sometimes you bind the voice. Or sometimes you doubt it. So God can speak to you audibly. He can speak to you about your healing audibly. Go and drink bitter leaf. I'm telling you. If you ask God, he will speak to you. If you ask him, he will say to you, go to General Hospital, go to Wuse General Hospital, and just go. And then you just go and stand there like Mumu. Before you know it, you will say, so God, say, follow him. And he goes and he solves your problem. Meaning that there are different ways to heal a problem, to heal that particular problem. But what Nigerians do is that if somebody drinks Ogu and it's good for them, we all drink Ogu. And nothing happens to us, because the word to drink Ogu was not to all of us. This thing has so freed me. Now I know. So God can tell you to, let me follow this in systematically. Another way God can speak to you is that the scriptures can just pop out. You are reading the Bible and something will just pow. And it will not be just a regular rhema. It will energize you and you will know that this is it. There's one scripture Christians quote, and every time I hear it, I get angry. I literally get angry. Affliction shall not arise a second time. And you know what? Affliction will arise. Because in this life, you will have tribulation. Is that not what the Bible says? So don't tell me affliction. God was speaking to Nahum that day at that very, for that, it, whatever. So, but then there are times God can speak to you and you know this is, it just jumps out. It consumes you. And you know this affliction will not rise again. You will know the time, the space, you heard it clearly. So there are times, it's not everything in the Bible that you can claim. My needs are met according to you. No, that is the general truth. But God, what is my specific word for my own situation? So sometimes scriptures will jump out at you. That is the second way God can speak to you. The third way God can speak to you is that you will hear a witness by the Spirit in your heart. A silent witness, and it will just be a witness. You will just know in your heart, beyond any unreasonable or reasonable shadow of doubt. So you get a specific word from God, however he chooses to. For some people, it may be through a preaching, or through a word, or through a book. But the three specific ways that God must speak is through the word, and whatever God says to you, it will bear witness with the scriptures. Okay, so let's go on. So until you clearly hear from God, don't do anything. Until you clearly hear from God, don't go to the embassy. Don't just do things because you can do them. Don't just go to a place because you can go here, there. Don't just buy things because you can buy them. Ask God, what do you want me to do? So until you get a clear word from God, you are not doing anything. Never presume that because God did a certain thing in the Bible, you can also require or demand him to do the same for you. He is God, not you. He is the God. So because he healed, because he provided wine for the people in the Bible, you don't now go and bring a pot or say, Father, do this miracle, because the Bible says yesterday, today, and forever. He will not change anything. He may just tell you, go and buy your wine and give your people to drink. It is the specific instruction that you hear from God that will deliver your personal and particular miracle. Did you hear me? It is the specific word you hear from God, specific instruction that will deliver your own miracle. This is where we have missed it as Christians. By his stripes we are healed. By his stripes I'm healed. No. God, what is my word? I know that by your stripes I'm healed. What should I do? And you know, I've told you the story of Pastor Dola. By the way, he was here like 2-3 weeks ago, and we had dinner in my house, and he talked and said different things. Cancer has attacked Pastor Dola like three times. And each time, he shuts the door and says, Father, what should I do? And each time, God has told him what to do. And every time he has gone back, the cancer disappeared. Because there is a specific word. There is a specific thing to do. There is a specific instruction God wants to give you. Question is, we are not asking, we just claim scriptures and we begin to and nothing happens. Me, I'm just tired of the Christianity that nothing happens anymore. I just want to do things deliberately and see results. Say amen.
Amen.
So Jesus said, fill the water with water, water pots with water, draw out. That was a clear, specific instruction for that day, for that occasion. When he needed to feed people with bread, he didn't say, bring whatever, fill dough and whatever and fetch and give the people. What did he say? Look for anybody who has bread, bring it to me. Different. Go through the Bible. Hardly has Jesus done anything the same way twice. Never. You know, as I read that book, I began to think through the scriptures. So it's the same feeding situation. He uses a different method. And then by the man by the well, by the pool, he said, rise up, take up your bed and walk. And then the paralytic, he says, your sins are forgiven you. And then to the blind man, he takes saliva and put it on his eyes. Everybody, you have a particular thing that is customized for you.
Thank you.